Hi, my name is Hope Yoder with Embellish, a division of R&K Distributing, and I'm here at home and thought today would be a good day to organize my Embellish tools. So I have this basket full of goodies and I'm going to organize it on this pegboard. Stay tuned. So I've got a pegboard and maybe you have a different system for organizing and I'd love to hear how you organize. But this is the area over my straight stitch machine where I do a lot of quilting, and right over there is my embroidery machine, and then I have my long arm machine. So I have my own little happy place, and I thought it'd be a really great idea to decorate it and organize it because I always like a little bit of inspiration. So if you have a pegboard, let me just show you what I think I'm going to do with this. And I've got a basket of goodies here. And with this basket, I've got my little hooks and I've got the things that I use most often. So I want those close by, and then I have other pegboards where I have that as well. So with this particular pegboard, I have all kinds of different accessories. And if you're wondering, this is just one I got at IKEA. It's very economical and that allows me for more money to play with the big toys that I want. So I'm gonna go ahead, and I have one hook up here already. And let me just start by getting my new embellish tools. And so we've got three tools, and these are so pretty. This is terrible to confess, but I actually have two pair of them because one, I just look at it in the pretty packaging, and the other I have around my whatever machine I'm sewing on. And because I think it's really important that when I, at least for me, when I craft or sew, I want to be inspired and I want to be around bright, happy colors and things that I think are pretty that inspire me. So let's go ahead and put a couple of these little pegs here, and I will hang my centerpiece here, my embellish tools. And what we have here, if you're wondering, this is our new seam rubber. And this has a really nice shiny tip on it. It has a little ball so it won't snag the fabric. But what I love most about it, besides the fact that it's just really pretty, is the fact that it has a really fine, thin micro tip. So it'll slip between the thread and the stitches. So that's our ergonomic precision seam ripper from Embellish. And oops, gotta go up higher here. And the next tool that I put, oh, those look so pretty. I probably need to organize them in from the tallest to the skinniest. Thin blade for close cut. Now these are applique scissors for machine applique or hand applique or for embroidery applique. They've got a really fine tip on them and big holes in the handle so that your hand doesn't get cramped, plenty of room to grab into. But what I love about them is they have this nice little curve, and that really helps me slip underneath a thread so when I'm trimming close. And the other tool that matches, whoops, let me get this little peg on here, is our embroidery tweezers. Now I use these for a couple different ways, and maybe I'll do a little video later, but when I'm trimming with my applique scissors, jump threads, things like that, I will actually pull the thread taut with the tweezers, and then I'll come in there and I'll snip it with the applique scissors. Another thing that I use the tweezers for is weeding vinyl. Once I use our weeding tool, which I'm gonna hang up here in a moment, and then I will actually just take the tweezers to pull it or to help get those little tiny slips of foil away. But my favorite place to use this week, because I'm at home, is on my long arm quilting machine. And my handle has a place, a little hole where my tweezers hang and then my applique scissors. So I'll show you a picture of what I mean. All right, so let me get these in order. See, these are about the same size, so I guess it doesn't matter. I'll hang my seam ripper here, and then I'll hang my tweezers and my applique scissors. Oh, next, I have the baby shark ergonomic comfort grip chenille cutter. Now, I don't know about you, you probably have different techniques that you like to do, but some of you may love chenille as much as I do because I have Embellish Maker software and I just like to turn any design into chenille to upscale it. So I want to make sure this is really close at hand. And this little chenille cutter, I wanted to make sure I had a really big hang hole put in this embellish tool because the hooks that I use here at my home are different than what I use at my office. The hooks are a little bit bigger, so we've got an extra large hang hole. And this is rubber, so that as I use it, my hand won't cramp. It's soft to the touch. And then there's a rest for your thumb or for your finger. And if you've never used this, it's almost like a coupon cutter. The rotary blade doesn't spin, it's stationary, so it works a little bit different than what a regular rotary cutter does. So I'm gonna hang this, and I, if you notice, I have the extra long guide because for straight chenille, I took off the short guide that comes with the package and I put on the long guide. So where do I want this? Maybe we'll just keep going here. And then I'll hang this right there. Ooh, I'm already inspired. I wanna stop and just embroider. But we've got these, and I have some tools that are open, and I'll show you how I organize those. But the next thing that I'm going to put up would be our embellish vinyl weeding tool. Now, this is not just for vinyl, and the little cap, just to show you so I don't lose it, I actually have it down in the bottom of this pouch. It's just a protective cap. But what I like to do is I will put it in the bottom of this pouch because normally I store the tip upside down and that just gives me a little bit of protection down there. And my new favorite thing for this is it's the perfect stiletto. It has a nice point to it. So as I'm sewing or quilting or piecing or especially chain piecing, oh my gosh, it's the best. I got this idea from Alex Anderson from our Quilter Select line. It's really nice and heavy and weighted so that you your hand doesn't get tired. It really reduces hand fatigue. So anything that I want to store like this, I could take my little basket. And I'm thinking I want to do this a little bit lower here so I can reach it. So anything open, I can put there. So if my scissors or my tweezers. Now, another thing that I use all the time for embroidery and for quilting, you can see how used it is. Yes, Quilter's Select Fabric Glue Stick. And you guys, I'm into paper piecing this week. And because I'm at home, I'm trying things I've never tried before. And this Quilter Select Glue Stick is perfect for a paper crafter or foundation paper piecing, for embroidery, for just about anything. And I actually use it on my long arm quilting sometimes for basting just little corners. So that's gonna go right there. Oh my gosh, these match all the teal. I'm loving it. All right, oh, here's my applique scissors that I normally have by my machine. And so they're open. So I'm gonna put that down, point down to be safe. Another thing that I love, 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 this little R&K tool, and it's a precision turning tool. Again, no packaging. I think that'd be good right there. Use my cordless battery operated rhinestone setter. So that doesn't have the package anymore. And these little crystals right here, I found this little tray. So I think this tray might be kind of nice. Let's put the tray here. Oh, I think it needs to go up one more hole. All right, we got the, ooh, I like that I have this little ledge there, but I'll put my crystals up here. And I have other things that I use a lot. So maybe the current threads, if I'm quilting or I'm doing machine embroidery, I would put up on this little shelf so I can see them. And then I have my thread storage rack. But let's say those are all organized like Kim or Paula did. When I'm using threads, I might want them up here on a little tray like this. So let's just kind of, we'll stick that there. So I'm gonna be sewing later today and I've got some happy fabric. So I have our Quilter's Select thread right here. And because I'm home, my husband has brought me a few pair of shorts. Well, actually, he brought them to me like a year ago, but he re-brought them to me since I'm home so much and said, could you please sew on this button? So I'm gonna do a little YouTube video for our newer sewers that are home and may wanna do some mending. So there's a hand sewing needle right here, and I love this color thread for that. And let's see what else I have that I'm gonna be working on. Oh, our embellish, we have new metallic thread. Now this thread comes in 10 beautiful colors. And if you watch Paula's video, she told you a lot about this thread, and it has a poly core with metal with mylar over it, and it's coated with mylar, so no metal ever touches metal on your sewing machine. It glides through perfectly. A great little tip is you could use it upside down so it unwinds beautifully. You don't have to do that. I actually use mine straight up because the mylar acts as a lubricating, or even though it's not wet, that's probably not the right word, but years and years ago, I used to use a little silicone product to help lubricate this through my machine. Well, with our R&K and embellish metallic threads, you don't need to do that because the mylar is kind of built in. It's a safety feature. And I'm going to be doing some long arm quilting, and I'm still learning long arm quilting, free motion quilting, and I love to use our flawless 60 weight thread. It's lighter weight, it's very strong, it's made of 100% polyester, and it kind of disappears into the quilt, which is really what I'm looking for as I learn when I do free motion. So that's our flawless 60 weight thread. And then some of our trending encore colors of thread. This is our 40 weight matte thread. And we have 130 colors in the line of thread, plus 15 extra colors that are trending encore colors. And that's what you see here. So maybe I have these kind of all lined up. I pick them out. That way I don't have to go back and find them again. So having a little tray is great. Now, another thing that I use all the time, I use the Embroidery Perfection tape from R&K. You can see how little is left. I might need some more of that. This is not painter's tape. People ask me all the time, well, isn't that just painter's tape? No, painter's tape doesn't stick to your fabric or your felt. It picks up all the lint, and it, you know, it's almost non-sticky when you use it for fabric. So this is actually just for placing or piecing or embroidery if you wanna baste with tape something on your embroidery hoop, like a topper, or maybe you want to lay down quilt, some batting and some fabric, and you don't have enough to hoop it all the way. Well, then you can use this. I also use this on my digital cutters. I use a Scan and Cut at the office and at home. I've actually got a couple of those. And sometimes there's things that don't want to stick to the mat real well, or maybe you're at home. And you know, we're supposed to stay in our home in Florida. The governor today at midnight, we're all homebound, and maybe I can't get a new cutting mat. So I can tape my material or my fabric or my foil to my digital cutting mat with the Embroidery Perfection tape. Now, the other tape that I use all the time is the 1/4 inch Embroidery Perfection tape, or no, I'm sorry, that's embroidery stitching tape, the R&K Stitch Perfection tape. I love this stuff, and I have no package for it. So let's see if I can put it behind here. And that kind of doesn't stick. So we'll put him up here. I think I have another place for that. Embroiderer, sewist, or quilter should be without this. This sucker is nice and heavy and weighted. That would be either in my bucket or in my tray. I'm back, and I have some rulers I want to organize on this side of my pegboard. So the first one I'm gonna place here is our embellished t-shirt centering ruler. Now, I don't know if you can see my t-shirt here that I'm wearing. If you can't see the bottom of it, it's E, embellish, we use our powers for good. And so this is one of my favorite t-shirts I made with our white heat transfer foil from embellish. Embellish ruler, we've got a nice big hang hole, and it looks like there's probably a nice, space for that. Let's go over a little bit, see if that'll work. Perfect. So we've got my ruler, and now the next thing that I might lay is I'm going to move on to quilter select rulers. You guys, I love these rulers. And I'm gonna kind of stack these in order of how I use them. There we go. This is for free motion quilting and it's super thick. Can you guys see how thick that is? Has the same nonstick coating. And this is actually made for free motion quilting on a sit down domestic machine with a ruler foot. You would need to have a ruler foot, free motion ruler foot, or you could use it on a long arm frame. And I made a little video on our Facebook page. You can see me using it. This is just to reposition and move it. You're not meant to quilt with your fingers in there. You're just gonna slide. To decorate with, now there's a lot of pretty color here, but these are some stitch outs from my animal art collage CD that aren't finished yet. And you can collage with fabrics and cork in the hoop. So let's just take, I got some little clips here and let's just see, because I want to be inspired. And so I want pretty things around me and I might take him and this little llama right there. Well, maybe he wants to be flying off with a little bit of Mylar. So make sure that you make your space pretty by hanging little in the work pieces of embroidery, or let me show you what I've been working on. I did foundation paper piecing and that was a lot of fun, and that's where I used this little glue stick. Let me go grab that sample. Here's my sample that I've been working on. This is my very first foundation paper piecing. I have a new little jelly roll. I have no idea what I'm gonna do with this. These are 1.5-inch strips, but I think that is pretty. So we'll hang that here. And I have our embellished stabilizer. And it looks like I've got no room left here, but maybe I need more pegboards. But this little thing hooks in, and then I could hold my, let's just see if I can get this last thing in here. All right, and if I get my fusible bowl tearaway, it's one of my favorites, that and our embellished fusible dissolvable tearaway. I use those all the time. Yep, I like that. So, and there is just an idea on how to organize some of your tools that you use all the time using a pegboard. And you can have these kind of all over the place. Maybe you just want a whole ruler pegboard, or a thread pegboard, or a bunch of shelves to hold your latest fabric. So tell me, what do you do in your studio to stay organized? I love the pegboards with all the accessories. What do you do? Thank you.